Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Here we're just finishing up a soil gas mat install on this house, and we've used this product because the builder did not put rock in. Typically you'd have 4 inches of clean gravel or rock, and then your poly, and then your concrete slab. So in this case, we've just got sand here. So we've got the soil gas mat, and how it works is it's a plastic that's about an inch tall, and then it's got this filter fabric. So when there's concrete poured, it's gonna support that and allow for radon gas, soil gases, and vapor to be drawn to our collection point. So the first step in installing this is setting our subgrade. So in this case, we're gonna have a 4 inch thick concrete floor. We're gonna have 2 inches of styrofoam under the entire floor. So that means we've got 6 inches to account for. So we set our subgrade at 7.5 inches, which gives us 1.5 inches for this. So we got about 1/2 inch of wiggle room. When installing this, you want to be within 1 foot of the exterior foundation walls, and then you can jog it around plumbing penetrations as well. So when we're doing seams and corners like this, we cut it in a 45, like so, and then we're going to overlap the two pieces a couple inches, and then we've got Gorilla tape that we tape the seam so we don't get concrete and dirt in there. And then we're gonna use 8-inch landscape staples to staple the two pieces together. And then at least every 7 feet, we've got a 60-penny nail. For added securement, we do use 10-inch spikes or the landscape staples. So we've got this running around the entire perimeter of the house. It comes back to our collection point here. And this is a tee provided by the manufacturer. So our soil gas mat comes in here, it's taped, we've got it secured with the staples, we've got our tee staped or secured with a 12-inch spike, and then we've got our riser pipe coming up that's going to come through the concrete. We've polyurethaned around here, and then we've got 4 stainless steel screws to hold this pipe in place. We've also polyurethaned that. So the next step is going to be for the concrete guys to come in. They're going to finish grading the floor. They're going to lay their poly down, their 2-inch foam, and then concrete. And then something that's really important and often overlooked with new construction is sealing. So all of our plumbing penetrations are going to be air leaks. Imagine that we're sucking on this and we've got all these leaks to the house right here. We lose conditioned air down these air leaks and out to the outdoors. Another spot we want to seal is going to be the floor to wall joint where the concrete meets this. As the concrete cures, it's going to shrink and pull back a little bit. So we've got an air gap there that we don't want that. So make sure that we seal those, any plumbing penetrations, and then bathtubs. We've got a couple bathtub blockouts. So that's important for that stuff to be sealed. The next step after that is going to be for the plumber to finish running the pipe. So they'll add on to that. They'll run up to the attic, want to make sure that they insulate the pipe in the attic. And then where it penetrates the roof, we also need an outlet to add a radon fan. Any questions, feel free to reach out to us. I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Thanks for watching.